The ear is divided into three regions. We have the outer ear, it goes from the penna to the tympanic membrane. We have the middle ear from the tympanic membrane to the underneath the stapes. And then we have the inner ear. It has the cochlea, the semicircular ducts, and then we have the vestibular cochlear nerve leaving the back. So the outer ear receives the sound, the middle ear amplifies the sound, and the inner ear transmits the sound. So receives starts with R, middle ear amplifies, so amplify starts with A, inner ear transmits, so it starts with T, so R-A-T. So the outer ear or the external ear has the penna. This is elastic cartilage. Its job is to funnel the sound waves down the auditory canal or external acoustic medius until it hits the tympanic membrane. The tympanic membrane is also called the eardrum. The sound waves hit it and it's going to vibrate. And in the middle ear, we have the auditory ossicles. So we have the malleus, the incis, and then we have the stapes. On this model is attached to the inner ear parts. We can see on this that we have the malleus, the incis, and the stapes. So the malleus looks like a hammer, the incis looks like an anvil, and the stapes looks like a stirrup. We also have this Eustachian tube. The Eustachian tube leads from the ear down to the nasal pharynx. Normally this tube is closed and it helps equalize the pressure on either side of this tympanic membrane. Underneath the stapes, we have the oval window, the cochlea is the hearing part of the ear, and the semicircular canals play a role in equilibrium. Leaving the inner ear, we have the cranial nerve number 8. This is the vestibular cochlear nerve. Takes the signal to the brain. Notice that the inner ear sits in the temporal bone, and we're going to take a closer look at the inner ear. So the cochlea looks like the snail shell. It has a membranous labyrinth called the cochlear duct inside. The oval window is where the stapes vibrates and causes the fluid to move inside the inner ear. The vestibular apparatus has the utricle and then also the saccule. These tell you where your head is located. So they're involved in your stationary equilibrium. The semicircular canals, we have 3 of them. These detect rotational movements of your head. They're going to send the signal to the vestibular cochlear nerve. This is cranial nerve number 8. And it's going to send that signal off to your brain. So the stapes is going to move the oval window in and out. That causes the pressure waves in the inner ear. And the round window is going to absorb any of those pressure waves from the cochlear duct.